I'd like to take a deep dive today into two great public speaking examples, Lady Gaga, Tony Bennett, and specifically a voice coach reacts to Lady Gaga, Tony Bennett interview with Anderson Cooper. Now, the reason I've chosen this is that I think it's a fascinating look at performance persona or personality. And it's really made me reflect on the way in which we can be so attached to who we think we are in the world. On the other hand, it also helps us understand how we can construct powerful performance personas to get us through those performance anxiety moments, particularly for public speaking, but also for singing, for any kind of performance situation. I'm SJ Harrison, voice and performance coach, and one of the reasons that I chose this was partly to contrast a previous video that I did on Lady Gaga receiving her award for Shallow and how different her presence is in this video and why, and also because I did another video on Haluk Bilginer winning an Emmy Award, and specifically for a series called Persona, in which his character has Alzheimer's. So there's a lot of different threads around the idea of aging, Alzheimer's, persona, performance persona, and how we can show up in very different ways in different situations. Now let's have a look at a few clips from this interview.
I left my heart in San Francisco.
My voice practice is based in San Francisco, and this makes me really emotional because it's such a wonderful city and a wonderful song.
But for Tony now, those years are a dim memory, lost in the fog of dementia from Alzheimer's. He spends much of his time in his New York apartment looking through books and old photos.
What are these of?
We met Tony and his wife Susan in June, a few weeks before his 95th birthday.
Is that Bob Hope?
Bob and Dolores.
They sent that for your 75th birthday, and in a month and a half, you're going to be 95. How about that?
It's amazing.
Do you feel 95? You don't look it.
How old do you feel, Tom?
95.
Tony has his good moments, but Susan has to do most of the talking.
So just really take him in there, the way he said 9 to 5, and he looked up and he was smiling, and he has a very open, almost childlike expression in the sense of just being very in the moment, not really having much of a past in terms of his experience, having very much the present that can happen for people with Alzheimer's. And the reason I'm pointing this out is because I really want us to see the performance persona in full relief.
Tony and Lady Gaga released their first album together in 2014. In 2018, he was able to record another album with her, which was just released this past week. By June, however, his disease had progressed, and Susan told us she wasn't sure exactly what would happen at the planned Radio City concert.
How you doing, handsome?
Okay.
You want to look over here at me?
But when it was time to rehearse, something incredible happened. Tony's accompanist, Lee Musiker, began playing, and suddenly, the legendary showman was back.
Let someone stop believing in you. Let him hold out his hand. Let him find you and watch what happens. Smile though your heart is aching. Smile even though it's breaking.
He had no notes, no cue cards.
When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by.
We were amazed. All his old songs were somehow still there. He sang an hour-long set from memory.
If you just smile.
Mm-hmm.
So that was an hour-long set.
That was incredible. So you just start playing something and it's all there?
When I start playing, Tony is completely engaged, and this is a whole new performance, and new phrases, new nuance, nothing short of a miracle.
Dr. Gayatri Devi explained how a transformation like that was possible.
People respond differently depending on their strengths. In Tony's case, it's his musical memory, his ability to be a performer. Those are an innate and hardwired part of his brain. So even though he doesn't know what the day might be or where his apartment is, he still can sing the whole repertoire of the American Songbook and move people.
How does music stimulate the brain?
It engages multiple different parts of the brain, right? So there's the auditory cortex for hearing. There's the part of the brain that deals with movement and dance. There's the visual system that gets engaged. So it's kind of like a whole brain activator.
So what I hear Dr. Devi talking about through my lens as a voice coach and performance coach is the power of the performance persona. So even as public speakers, we're not singing, but we're using so many of those elements when we perform. For example, embodied performance incorporates breath, intention, our feelings, our voices, and our bodies, all working together. And these are heightened moments. And in order to show up for heightened moments, such as performance, we have to practice how to bring all of those things together in one place in a confident way. And so sometimes with my clients, depending on what they're struggling with, I suggest that they develop their own authentic performance persona. Tony Bennett is completely authentic when he's performing. He's fully himself. And yet it's a different self than just being in a room with him. Even before, he would have had a heightened persona, just as Lady Gaga does. And you will see this here too, because we're going to look at Lady Gaga as well. So although he has lost so many elements of himself, so many aspects of his personality are not accessible to him anymore, this one knows what to do and comes out and takes over. And we too can develop that persona to help us in performance.
Tony could remember the songs, but could he remember how to perform them in front of thousands of people? Lady Gaga knew it wasn't going to be easy.
And you know, Anderson, for the first couple of weeks that I saw Tony since COVID, he called me sweetheart. But I wasn't sure he knew who I was.
In rehearsals this July, she found new ways to connect and communicate with her old friend. When asking him questions, she'd keep it simple.
For example, if I were to say, Tony, would you like to sing Love for Sale? He'll say, yeah. And if I say, Tony, would you like to sing Love for Sale? Or it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. He might not have as easy of a response.
Do you want to sing Anything Goes?
Yeah.
All right, great. Anything Goes, everyone.
When that music comes on, it's something happens to him. He knows exactly what he's doing. And what's important for me, actually, just to make sure that I don't get in the way of that.
So here's the other thing I wanted to look at with Lady Gaga, because a few weeks ago I did a video on her winning the award for Shallow when emotion completely took over. And that was one aspect of her personality that we saw when she's in the grip of complete emotion and really having a hard time being able to control that. Well, this here is not either her persona or her high emotion. This is just her talking with Anderson Cooper, feeling very natural, not feeling on the spot. Sure, there's a camera recording her, but she's present with the interviewer. And a great interviewer helps you do that. A great interviewer helps you relax and just be yourself. The other thing that I think is probably really nice for Lady Gaga here is that the whole thing is about Tony Bennett. She's talking about her experience with him. She's feeling her emotions of love for her friend Tony Bennett. She's wanting to communicate her experience, and it's very low key. So we see her in this completely natural moment without her persona. Stay tuned for part two coming Thursday next week. We will look at Tony Bennett and Lady Gaga performing at Radio City Music Hall. Check out my free guide, Empower Your Voice, in the text below. Like and subscribe, and you can also check out last week's video on Haluk Bilginer, the Turkish bilingual actor. Here's to unlocking your performance power.